Is Pop home yet?
No, he'll be a little late. I had to phone him at the job and tell him to stop by the landlord and pay the rent only if he absolutely swore he'd get us a new icebox.
Hey, Babs, I don't want you talking about boys at supper tonight.
Don't tell me what topic of conversation to choose. Go peddle your papers, infant.
Look, I just want to keep Pop in a good mood. I got something very important to ask him.
Don't tell me you're going to marry Marilyn Morris. It'll be delightful having the landlord's daughter as a sister-in-law.
Why don't you wet a piece of confetti and drown your brain?
Good evening, Junior.
Hi, Mr. Binney.
Miss Barbara.
Hello.
Is your father home?
Riley, is that you?
No.
Oh, hello, Mr. Binney. I thought it was Riley. I guess he's having a battle with the landlord.
Oh, what a shame.
It's our refrigerator. It's a piece of junk.
Well, Mr. Riley asked me to be here at 6 o'clock with certain information.
Information about what?
Well, he told me I shouldn't show it to anybody else.
Oh, another one of my husband's big deals. Last time it was oil wells in Alaska. Oh, excuse me, I got a dead fish out there.
Well, while I'm waiting, I'll do a little bit of yogi.
Anything about the icebox? Is she upset?
Well, she is quite perturbed.
Mr. Binney, have you had supper? Riley!
Hiya, Dumplin.
Oh. Well, what did he say? Why are they delivering the new box?
The box?
The refrigerator. You just came from the landlord's, didn't you?
Peg, my friend Walter was here. I don't think we should discuss family matters in front of a stranger.
Well, maybe I better go.
Oh, no, you stay, Walter.
I want a straight answer from you. Did you go by Mr. Morris's like I told you and tell him no icebox, no rent?
Now, Peg, don't get excited. You see, when you called me up, I thought over the whole situation. Number one, why do you want a new refrigerator?
Why do you think?
To keep the food cold.
Right.
Who wants ice? I want a new electric refrigerator. Did you give him the rent?
I should say not. Not 1 cent. Do me a favor, Waldo. Put this in the refrigerator.
Yeah.
Well, you might just as well put it in the sink, because I'm going to have to take out all the shelves first.
Hurry up, Waldo.
You
it's
can
awful
consider
cold.
It done. No?
Look at that.
Yeah, well, you can depend on me.
No.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi, Babs.
Now, what did the landlord say?
I didn't see him.
Huh?
I got more important things to do with my money than paying rent.
But, Daddy, you've got to pay rent. He can put us out.
Just let me have the money. I'll go over there myself.
Now, please, Peg, I'm the head of the house. I'll still take care of the money matters.
Where is the $40?
I was just coming to that, Peg. Today, I made an investment.
Oh, Daddy. The money we need to keep a roof over our heads?
Now, Peg, don't get excited. It's something I always wanted.
Go ahead.
A college education.
College? But you never graduated high school.
Oh, darling, you've been working too hard lately.
There it is, Dumplin. 4 years of college. It's an educational insurance policy. You see, Chester Riley, Jr.
Oh, it's for Junior.
Yeah, ain't it wonderful?
Yeah, it's a fine idea.
Well, I got the ice in. Now there's no room for the food.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Binney. Yeah.
Oh, you got Junior's college policy.
Yes, if he ever gets through high school.
Waldo, all we have to do now is pick out a college for the kid to matriculate at.
Well, I have data here on 20 top universities. Here's Wormser College.
Wormser?
Marblestone Medical.
Here might be a doctor.
Herman Spachenberger Normal. My alma mater.
My alma mater. It's down in Florida. Down south.
Say, but you know about these policies. I thought they had to be taken out when a child was very young.
Oh, no. The agent gave me a special deal. All I had to do was pay some back premiums. And 4 years from today, Junior will have enough dough to go to college.
This is Dr. Birnbaum's veterinary college.
But how do we know that Junior's going to want to go to college?
He'll be dying to go. He's my son, ain't he?
Oh, but you didn't go to college, dear.
That's just it. He's smart enough not to want to grow up like me.
Oh, you want a profession.
Yeah, it's fine to have a profession.
He'll be a big professional man. Hey, Junior.
You home, Pop?
Yeah, I'm home. Come out here for a minute, will you, Junior? Gee, imagine. Imagine how proud we'll be. Someday, Junior will come home from college and on his head he'll be wearing a Phi Beta cap.
Oh! Hiya, Pop.
Hiya, son. I want to have a little talk with you, Junior.
Your father's got plans for you, dear.
About school.
Well, gee, that's funny. I wanted to talk to you about the same thing. I've got some plans, too.
Did you hear that, Peg?
Yeah.
What did I tell you? Go ahead, Junior. You tell me your plans, and then I'll tell you mine.
Well, Pop, I've been thinking, and I want to quit high school.
Okay. After you graduate college? What did you say?
I said I want to quit high school.
Quit? What is he saying?
Quit school? I should say not.
But, Mom...
I never heard of such a thing.
Now, perhaps if we approach this matter calmly...
The whole thing is ridiculous. You're going to get an education now. We see to that.
Oh, what good is school?
What good is it? Waldo, tell him.
Well, first of all...
Please, Waldo, don't interrupt. What do you expect to get without an education? Look at Abraham Lincoln.
Lincoln quit school?
Did? Well, there you are. Maybe if he had an education, he'd have gotten further.
No, why on earth do you want to quit school?
I'm sick of it. A lot of fellas I know quit school and went to work. I can get working papers.
You will not. Look, Junior, I'm only trying to make life easier for you. I want you to be somebody. The world's got to improve. So everybody can have a chance for a little happiness. That takes leadership. You see, an education helps you to think. I know, because I didn't have one.
Look, dear. Look what your father did for you today. He got this policy, this college policy, so you'd have money to go to college.
And I've had a lot of fine schools for you to choose from.
Gee, that's swell, Pop. But I just don't want to go to college.
Junior, how can you say that? Look at all the fun you're going to have. Rooting at the football games and dancing at the senior proms, mingling with the maternity crowd.
Fraternity.
Yeah, them too.
Dear, the main thing is about college. It prepares you for a career, see?
But I don't want a career. I just want to go to work.
You're not going to work. You're going back to school.
No, I won't.
Don't say that you won't. I'm the head of this house, and whatever I say goes. You're going back to school.
No, I won't. I won't. I won't.
Junior, come back here.
What's all the yelling? Your brother wants to quit school and go to work.
What? Oh, the drip.
I don't understand it. All of a sudden, he loves work. Well, he certainly don't get it from me.
This is serious.
Guess I better have a talk with him.
It'll do you no good. You'll get nowhere. He's stubborn like your side of the family. Waldo, I gotta make him go back to school.
Oh, what he needs is a good spanking.
Spanking? No, no. I'm not spanking him until he's as big as I am. I don't want him to hate me for being a bully.
Well, perhaps if we used another approach, a psychological approach.
Psychological approach. I got it. He wants to go to work? Okay, let him.
Oh, be serious, Daddy.
I am serious. I know that boy.
Popeye.
Oh, Junior. I was just going to call you. I have thought the whole thing over, and I have decided that you can quit school.
I can.
Are you sure, Pop? As a matter of fact, I insist on it. You're going to work.
Oh, jeepers, that's keen. Hey, look, will you sign these so I can get my working papers?
Who's got a pen?
Here's a pen, Mr. Riley, but are you sure?
There's nothing further to discuss. Junior's going to work.
I think this whole thing is ridiculous.
You pipe down. Pop knows what he's doing.
You bet I know what I'm doing. Hey, yeah.
Well, is everything all settled?
Yeah, just perfect.
Junior's quitting school.
What?
You were all wrong about Pop, Mom. He wants me to quit. Gee, thanks. You're terrific.
Are you out of your mind?
Now, believe me, Peg, I know what I'm doing. I'm using psychology.
Psychology? Do you realize I had him convinced he should stay in school? He promised.
Did?
Yes.
Well, why didn't he tell me?
Oh, you never gave him a chance, Daddy.
Oh. Anyway, it's better this way. If I made him go back to school, he'd be sore at me. Sort of frustrated? Yeah, frustrated. Besides, let him take a job for 1 week. That'll cure him awake for the rest of his life.
You march right in there and tell him he's going back to school.
Now, please, Peg, there's only one way to put a stop to that kid, and it's psychology.
Psychology? What do you know about psychology?
What do I know about it? Plenty. Psychology is where one guy outsmarts another, ain't it?
Well?
Well, I've been outsmarted by many a guy.
You sure have, and Junior's one of them.
Now, please, Peg, I know that boy. I got him in the hollow of my head. Now, let's have supper.
Anybody home?
In here, Daddy.
Hiya, Dublin. Hiya, Babs.
Hello, Daddy. Tired,
is,
dear?
Junior home yet?
No.
Good. I want to be here when Mr. Working Man gets home.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Pop. Hi, Babs.
Are you tired, dear?
Who, me? Never felt better in my life.
But not on that. Well, Junior, how do you feel after your first day's hard work?
Great. 100%. Say, Mom, is supper ready? I'm so hungry I could eat a horse.
You don't fool me for a minute.
All right, dear, go wash up.
Say, I gotta eat fast. I'm going back to the warehouse and put in some overtime.
You are? Well, I'll go. Oh, I better get dinner going.
Old say, Pop, about the other night, I got a confession to make.
You hate work?
Oh, no, I love it. But when we had that argument, well, I was just sort of feeling you out. If you hadn't said I could quit, I'd still be in school.
Wash up.
You and your psychology.
There's nothing wrong with my psychology. Can I help it if he don't understand it?
Mother! Mother, it's a COD for you. The boy's waiting for $3.
Oh, Riley, give Babs $3 for the boy.
$3 for what?
Well, I bought a hat. There was a sale, you know. And...
A hat? You just bought a new hat.
A year ago. Come on, the boy's waiting.
Money, money, money. What do you think I'm made of, money? Dumplin, give back the hat. You look nicer in a naked head, honest.
Okay, I didn't like the hat very well anyway. Go on, tell the boy something. Tell him anything.
Wait a minute, Babs. Here's $3 for the hat.
Junior.
And here's an extra quarter, tip for the boy.
No, dear, no, I can't let you do this.
Oh, forget it, Mom. And from now on, anytime you need money, just let me know.
Now, wait a minute, Junior.
That's okay, Pop, I can afford it. I made a deal to get paid a dime for each crate I nail instead of by the day. I made $8.
Oh, wait a minute, dear. I can't let you do that. Your father handles the money matters around here. He's still the head of the house.
Well, I didn't mean...
You heard what your mother said. I'm still the head of the house. And around this house, whatever your mother says goes.
I'm sorry.
As long as I'm the head, I'll pay the bills.
Well, I wish you'd pay the phone bill, Daddy. We got a final notice yesterday.
I'll pay it, I'll pay it.
I paid it on my way home. Here's the receipt. And when next month's bill comes, just let me have it.
That settles it. Peg, I'm not going to stand for this interference. For 13 years, I paid that phone bill my way. Now he's paying it his way, on time.
Don't get so excited.
No, Peg, I'm putting my feet down. You want to be the head of the house? Okay, you're the head of the house. I'm abdicating, I'm through. I'm washing my hands and face off of it.
Oh, come on, Pop.
No, Junior, you're the head of the house. I want you to sit at the head of the table. I want you to carve the roast. I want you to exterminate the ants. And you stole off the landlord. I'll just be an insolent bystander.
I was afraid his psychology was a wee bit too daring.
There's nothing wrong with my psychology. I started with Junior, and now I'll finish him.
But you can't let things go on like this, dear. You've got to do something.
There must be some way to make him quit his job. Perhaps if you raised his allowance.
50 cents to $30 a week?
Look what Junior made this week.
Oh, no.
He should be giving me an allowance.
Oh, Mom. Oh, hi, Mr. Binney.
Junior.
Say, Mom, I'm hungry. Is supper ready?
Yeah, it's ready. Riley, would you like to eat now?
Don't ask me. He's the boss around here now. Ask him.
Oh, cut it out, Pop.
Please, Riley.
No, no, no. He's the boss. When he's ready to eat, we'll all eat.
I don't want to be head of the house, Pop.
You don't? Then will you go back to school?
Well...
Please, Junior.
No, you said I could quit.
All right, all right. You're making the decisions. Keep on making them.
I don't want to make the decisions, Pop. I just want to keep working.
He He's gone, Peg. Give me a sandwich, will you?
Just because he lost your temper, you see?
Well, believe me, he'll quit. Wait till he sees how tough it is to be a working man. Wait till he goes bankrupt.
Hi, all. Oh, more trouble with that brat.
Your father is still using psychology. I wish I knew where Junior got the crazy idea to quit school and go to work.
Oh, I've got news for you about that.
What?
You know, Junior's big heartthrob.
You mean that little girl, Marilyn Morris?
The landlord's daughter?
Yes. Well, it seems Junior has a rival for her affection. Some rich little squirt with a car and a chauffeur and buys her expensive presents.
What's that got to do with Junior?
Well, Junior wants to make money and be a big shot, too.
How do you like that?
That's silly.
I suspected there was a woman at the bottom of this.
Sure. Only a woman could make a man make the supreme sacrifice and go to work.
May I use the phone?
You paid for it. Go ahead.
Use it. Cut it out, will you, Pop?
I still have to eat. Hello, Mr. Morris. This is Chester Riley. Is Marilyn there?
Why don't you marry her? Maybe your father will give us an icebox for her dowry.
Perhaps Junior would like to talk privately.
He paid for that phone, but I bought this here rug.
Oh, hi, Marilyn.
Oh, hello, Chester, dear. How are things at the office?
Oh, swell. Say, what time shall I call for you?
Well, the dance starts at 8. Shall we say 7:30-ish?
Okay, I'll be by at 7:30. Bye.
Wait a minute, Junior.
Yeah, Pop?
You're not going to be the head of the house no longer.
I'm not. Oh, boy, that's swell, Pop.
From now on, I make all decisions.
That's okay with me.
And my first decision is that you ain't going out tonight.
What? But, Pop, I've got a date.
That's all? That's final? My head is made up.
But, Pop, I just got to go out.
Mr. Riley.
Please, Waldo, get on that phone and tell that girl you're not taking her to that dance. And you're not leaving this house until you go back to school.
I'll never go back to school. I don't care if I rot in this house.
Do you think you can get your money back for Junior's college policy?
That's the thanks you get for giving birth to a boy. Hello, Mr. Morris. This is Riley across the street. You tell your kid that my kid ain't taking her to that dance.
Why not?
Because I forbid him.
What about the rent?
What about a new icebox?
Oh, yeah? Well, the same to you.
What's wrong with Junior? He's locked himself in his room, and I think he's crying.
I think I better be going.
I'm teaching your son a lesson.
Oh, no, he's my son.
I told him he couldn't see that Marilyn Morris until he went back to school.
You didn't.
Oh, but, Daddy, he had his heart set going on the dance tonight.
He's not going to that dance or any place else until he goes back to school. If I have to keep him locked in that room till he's an old man.
Hello, Ben Apps.
Oh, hello, Marilyn.
Hello, Mrs. Riley.
Hello, Marilyn.
Mr. Riley.
Is there something I can do for you?
Mr. Riley, I'm going to be frank. I don't approve of the way you've been treating my Junior.
You're Junior. Let's get one thing straightened out. I'm Junior's father. Tell her.
How can any father subject his son, a sensitive man like Junior, to such an ordeal as you have subjected him to this past week?
Now, wait a minute.
Listen, dear, I'm afraid this is none of your concern.
Oh, I don't mean to be rude, Mrs. Riley, but Junior's happiness does concern me. And why should Mr. Riley forbid him to see me?
He can see you all he wants as soon as he goes back to school.
Oh, is that it? Well, then why don't you make him go back?
Make him go back? I tried everything. I reasoned with him. I argued with him. I tried to get him fired. I spoke to a school teacher. Nothing I did helped. I can't do a thing with that boy.
Well, I can. I think I can get him to go back to school.
You can?
Let's not be ridiculous.
I think I know a way to get him to go back.
There's no way. He's hopeless.
I'd like to speak to him, please.
Okay, but you'll see it's useless. Junior!
Yes?
Come in here for a minute. You'll see. I know that boy.
What do you want? Oh, Marilyn.
Marilyn has something to say to you, Junior.
Junior?
Yes, Marilyn?
Junior, tomorrow you are to go back to school.
Yes, Marilyn.
Holy smoke. He said yes, Peg. Did you hear him? He said yes.
Yeah. Now may he take me to the dance?
Oh, boy, I'll change my suit.
Oh, Riley, do you look foolish?
Why should I look foolish? I told you I'd get him to go back to school, didn't I?
Oh, you got him to go back, huh?
Yeah, in a roundabout way. I used psychology. I gave him enough rope and he almost hung me.
Oh, I almost forgot, Mrs. Roddy. Tomorrow you're getting a new refrigerator.
We are.
But I just spoke to your father and he told me to drop.
I convinced him that since Junior and I were planning to be married.
Married?
In 1957, my future in-laws were entitled to a decent refrigerator. Daddy saw the point. Well, I better go now. I gotta get dressed. Bye, folks.
You know, Peg, I don't know what kind of a wife she's gonna make. But 40 years from now, somebody's gonna have a terrific mother-in-law.